Hello, everyone, and welcome to our webinar on how to become a video security superhero in transportation and logistics. My name is Scott Spalek, and I am the Video Security Solutions Executive for Konica Minolta, based out of sunny Southern California. So, wherever you are around the globe, I hope you'll find this webinar informative. And I hope you will gain some insight on how you can improve outcomes in your business using this fantastic technology. So you may have heard of Konica Minolta in the past. You may have done some business with us. We're leaders in the area of imaging, print management, and document management. So you've probably known us for that, but you don't probably know that we're a major shareholder in a company called Mobotics that's been making intelligent security cameras since 1999. And recently we became the major distributor for Mobotics cameras in North America, which means better access from a supply chain standpoint to the products and services related to our video technology. So, really important to know that these cameras are manufactured and tested in Germany, so known for high quality and high standards. The other thing is that the cameras are NDA approved, very secure, and to date we've probably deployed over 1.5 million devices worldwide. The cameras are known for their decentralized architecture, which means they can actually work independently, but they also can work with popular video management platforms, either on-premise or in the cloud. So the cameras, you might think of your typical video camera that basically records and then you have to review what it recorded like the next day, usually after the fact or something actually happened. But our cameras are much different. We like to say they're really computers with lenses. And there's just an example of one of the form factors here in the top right-hand corner where the camera's brains can be hidden, for example, inside a wall or behind a wall with the lenses exposed and not really noticeable to the general public. The picture on the left shows our cameras in action where they're actually recording a bee in flight. And a bee, if you probably didn't know this, I didn't know this before I investigated our technology, is that a bee flaps its wings at about 300 cycles a second. So typically, when a camera records video using a standardized codec like H.264, the still image will sometimes be blurred. So, for example, if that was a car's license plate, car traveling by, and the codec leverage was H.264, that license plate might be blurry. We can employ our Mobotics proprietary codec that actually smooths that image and also can provide, evidentiary video that's very exact. So we can actually see, for example, that license plate clearly when we still the image and share it with like law enforcement, for example. And in this case, we can actually see the sheen on the bee's wings leveraging our proprietary Mobotics codec, by the way, which is free of any licensing, which could be really important for you from a purchasing perspective. In the bottom left-hand corner, you'll see these two individuals working on a camera that's actually on the top of Mount Everest. It's been there for over 10 years. And happy to say it's still operational, runs off solar power, and communicates via satellite to a headend on the ground that shows recordings of what it captures on top of Mount Everest. Very durable, and that's a keynote of the mobotics cameras. A lot of the cameras that we have in our portfolio have no moving parts, so that allows us to seal them in enclosures. And also because they don't have moving parts, we don't have to worry about wear and tear, which typical cameras that do have moving parts aren't going to last to the degree and time length of these mobotics manufactured cameras. The other thing that you probably realize is that these are IP-based devices, right? So they're connected to your network. And one of the things you really have to be concerned about with any type of network device is exposure of your network to folks that are trying to implement like viruses or ransomware. So we employ what we call the cactus concept, where the cameras are actually third-party tested, hardened. They use a proprietary Linux system, and everything on the camera is encrypted. If, for example, one camera did get infected, it also has the capability to shut down and not infect any other devices on the network. So, very important that when you are, deploying any kind of network device, you are doing everything possible to make sure that you're not allowing hackers to penetrate your network. And this cactus concept, this rigor that we employ with our devices, really helps mitigate those types of situations. So everyone has a different type of use case for video security, and we have a very large portfolio of different form factors that can invoke different lenses and camera types and mounting configurations, which can be really important based on your particular scenario. Pole mounted, vehicle mounted, on top of buildings in harsh conditions, as I mentioned before, and will likely, most likely, have the right camera with the right lens for your particular need. Okay, so let's get to the meat of it. Why are we all here? To learn about how we can apply this technology in transportation and logistics. So first area might be license plate recognition and optical character recognition, right? So license plate recognition, identify vehicles, class, model, color. We might have a stolen car, right, that we're trying to track down. How can we use this technology to find that car quickly, identify it, and then recover that as soon as possible? Or maybe we're going to use optical character recognition, to read information on the side of a 18-wheeler, for example, and communicate logistically where that vehicle is and when we might be able to get those goods that are on that truck, right? Let's take a look at leveraging license plate recognition. One example might be instead of using the old method of a sticker on your windshield, just leverage the license plate. And today we see that on a lot of more modern tollways where we get faster passage at toll booths, so we're not having to stop and wait, or have a ticket. I used to travel on the New York State Thruway and had to get a ticket when I checked in and when I checked out and make a payment, and it just slows up the traffic exponentially. So faster passage at toll booths. The vehicles also can be detected, looking up into a database. We can see through the license plate, make sure that vehicle is registered to that particular car, that make, model, and car in a database. And if there are some discrepancies, alert authorities that somebody probably got their plate stolen and they applied them to a different car, to do something that may be an issue. The other thing is locating vehicles that are under investigation. One great example of how we've put this technology into practice. The Westchester County Police Department, Westchester County, New York, actually mounted our cameras on top of their squad cars, and they tied that into a into their vehicle system, and were able to detect an individual that was kidnapping a child from Florida and is actually driving up the 95 to apparently take that child to Canada. And when they got to New York, Westchester County, the squad car that had our cameras mounted on the top of the car detected that license plate, looked it up in a database, and flagged it to be pulled over. And that thwarted, you know, a potential huge disaster, right? Saved that child's life, you know, leveraging license plate recognition. So a great way that, you know, from a safety perspective, this kind of technology, this kind of capability can really pay off. So video technology can be really important from a traffic management standpoint. We talked a little bit about the toll booths and, you know, automating that process. But here on the highway, you know, we can detect speeds of traffic, vehicle types, trucks, cars, motorbikes, how fast the traffic is going. And then that can tie into a bigger system. For example, the transportation in LA leverages this type of technology to really control traffic and traffic patterns throughout the city of LA, and can actually relay that information through their traffic management and controls, their, you know, the traffic light system to speed up traffic. So taking advantage of video security in this kind of scenario can really help a, you know, a city government, county government really improve outcomes from a traffic standpoint. Vaxter is a technology company that is now part of Mobotics. They've developed AI applications for several transportation applications. And here is an example of Vaxter software that recognizes the ID numbers issued by the ICAO and the FAA, which are located on the outside of airplanes and helicopters. You may not know this, but many private planes and light aircraft that travel are not equipped with a transponder. This is where the app comes in, as it helps to identify and track aircraft in real time as they move, take off, or land. So this is a valuable tool for safety, particularly for small airports with limited human resources. Well, I don't know about you, but one of the frustrating things when you're trying to park at a popular public spot is finding a parking spot. Well, as a video superhero, you can alleviate lots of stress for those drivers by employing video cameras where there are AI parking app. With the parking app, the cameras can detect free and occupied parking spaces. The cameras, utilizing their interactive capabilities, can work in conjunction with overhead lighting systems that are color-coded. A green light overhead, an open spot, can quickly point the driver in the right direction. Other ways you can use the cameras is to provide access control by reading the license plate and then opening a security gate. College campuses can really take advantage of this capability by utilizing the camera's intelligence to record authorized and unauthorized vehicles in their lot. This is much better and much more cost-effective than employing a traffic monitor that drives around all day looking for stickers on windshields. Today, sending your child to school creates a level of anxiety for parents. Putting your child on a school bus where they may be subject to bullying, unfortunately, has become a major concern. That's why many school districts have employed security cameras on their buses to record incidents of bullying, vandalism, and other bad behaviors, as well as accidents. Here's a specific use case at Canyon High School in Utah. Administration implemented 360-degree cameras to record incidents. On the right, you can see the hemispheric view recording the driver and the road up ahead. Another in the camera in the back of the bus also shows the entire scene. If incidents occur, the cameras can record those incidents and then allow authorities to quickly review footage. The cameras consume low power, so it doesn't tax the bus's energy system. And recording can be on a server in the bus, or it can be transmitted over a cellular network. Okay, so one of the problems of being a superhero is that you can't be everywhere all the time. However, being a video superhero, we can make that all possible. By implementing our cameras in designated areas, we can monitor activities and send real-time alerts to the authorities using artificial intelligence. Here's an example of AI applications that we can put into practice. Because our cameras are really computers with lenses, we can implement applications right into the camera and trigger real-time alerts based on what the camera sees. Here's just a sample list of applications we can put into use. In addition, we do have system developer kits that can allow you to develop your own applications. The other thing with these applications, they can be licensed per camera, and that can significantly cut down on costs. I think we all are becoming familiar with utilizing facial recognition to access our phones, but with AI facial recognition applications, we can also put that technology into great use within public transportation and public access on our cameras. Here we have access to public transportation as these folks pass through a turnstile, and that the camera may eliminate the need for HID cards or other legacy technologies. Cameras equipped with facial recognition software can detect the person and allow access. If the camera can flag a person that might be a threat to the environment, authorities can be alerted immediately and potentially thwart off a very dangerous situation. Okay, so we've talked a lot about public transportation, but let's shift to the supply chain and logistics. I don't know about you, but over the past few years, I think there's been lots of frustration knowing exactly where goods are in the supply chain. License plate and vehicle container applications on the camera can pinpoint exactly where a vehicle is in the supply chain, and that can lead to much better outcomes and less frustration. So here we see a truck pulling up to a depot. License plate recognition and OCR applications can read the license plate and container ID and record it on a BMS. The application records time, ID numbers, and the speed of the vehicle. If there is an issue based on what the camera sees, that can be quickly communicated and recorded. Also, later, authorities can quickly search through a database if an incident did occur, and that can save lots and lots of time replaying hours of video. Okay, once those goods get into the warehouse, cameras can integrate with warehouse management systems to scan the goods coming in and then track it as it makes its way throughout your warehouse. If you're in the logistics business, this application can pinpoint any kinds of issues that may occur while those goods are in your possession and then communicate those effectively with your customers. This can save literally millions of dollars in losses and maybe potential insurance claims. Our cameras are ONVIF compatible and they integrate with VMS platforms that utilize this standard. Here, the VMS gives the operator a graphical map view In this example, it's an airport. The operator can click on the map and bring up a specific camera in that location to stream in real time what is happening. Using this technology, you can significantly eliminate human resources. Literally, a few people can sit at a video wall and monitor hundreds of cameras all over the globe. The AI built into the cameras can alert operators to specific incidences using the applications that we've discussed so far. Okay, so let's say, superhero, you're in charge of securing a large area, let's say like a airport, seaport, and there's miles and miles of perimeter that you want to detect any intruders coming over day and night along this big area. In the past, you'd have to hire lots of security folks to patrol that area. But utilizing perimeter protection and sophisticated cameras with specific lenses, we can achieve the same result, cutting down significantly on that human resources need. Okay, so here you can see one of our popular cameras, the M16. It has dual lenses. One is the thermal radiometry lens and the other is optical lens. On the right side of the screen, the thermal radiometry lens detects a person in total darkness over 150 meters away. The optical lens on the left shows our activity sensor, and you can see that in the top left-hand corner of that shot. And it shows the direction of that individual, which way they're actually moving, which can be effective to see if they're coming towards the perimeter or away from it. You can see how these cameras are mounted on the pole in space at specific intervals, and that's determined by the lens we use and what we're trying to achieve from a perimeter protection perspective. As I mentioned before, these cameras have no moving parts, and they can last for years in very, very harsh conditions. And that could be really important from a cost standpoint to protect, let's say, for example, a seaport, airport, school boundaries, sports fields, stadiums, etc. During the pandemic, and even to this day, there's been huge problems getting goods off ships because of a lack of resources to unload them and then transport them to their specific destinations. Video surveillance can trap ship movements, giving logistic companies better data on where those goods are and then be able to relay those effectively to their customers. Here's a great use case at the Port of Antwerp. Video surveillance and the data recorder to their video management system provided high quality images, providing proof of damage for law enforcement, saving substantial amount of time and money. Their surveillance also improved management of shipping traffic, reduced incidents of vandalism, and also provide ability to protect the environment in instances of, let's say, oil leaks. Port authorities from a central location now can be alerted in real time to initiate action earlier to mitigate the impacts of these types of incidents. Okay, so now it's time to hero up and become that video security superhero that we all know you can be in transportation and logistics. And I've shared quite a bit of information with you over the last 30 minutes, and I hope it's really opened your eyes the way you can leverage this technology to solve real world problems in your business. As the technology continues to evolve, Konica Minolta will be there with you in partnership to help improve your operations. Here's a few things that I think are important as you investigate using this technology in your business. The first thing I would do is identify key stakeholders and their areas of concern, and then prioritize those concerns and weigh them against associated costs and the return on investment. I would also find a partner like Konica Minolta that will take the time to assess your current situation. On the right-hand side of the screen, here's an example of an assessment that we recently did with a customer that runs a warehouse in northern part of the United States. You can see where we plotted out cameras and camera types, and then we focused on the areas of concern to make sure that we capture key areas and movements in their warehouse. From there, I would also evaluate those recommendations and then weigh them against the return on investment. Also, I've posted a few links here that I think would be helpful for you as you continue to investigate this type of technology. You can see developments that we are taking in this area on our website. And then also, I would also make a recommendation to visit the Mobotics website, where you can see information on video technology and how it's being used in key industries and verticals. And last but not least, please feel free to reach out to us. Contact us. We'd love to talk to you more about your current situation and how we might be able to help. So again, my name is Scott Spalak. I've really appreciated the time you've spent with us today, and I hope you have a great rest of the day, and hero up.